Entrepreneurs Board of Investors is challenging America to pitch the next big idea during a 60-second elevator ride.
Time's up.
You need to walk in with a strategy that you know is going to work.
You need 5 million product, I take care of that.
Oh, they've got something here.
Let us decide if we think it's compelling enough.
If the pitch fails...
You choke so easily.
He's breaking the cardinal rule of pitching.
Send him down.
Going down.
No!
But if the pitch is successful...
I think we have to open it.
Open the doors!
Welcome to the boardroom.
Boom, mother.
And it's not just up to the judges. Entrepreneur Elevator Pitch lets you, the viewer, get in on the action through crowdfunding.
We have a deal.
Yay!
Is the next billion-dollar idea on its way up? This is Entrepreneur Elevator Pitch.
Going up.
Ready, judges? Let's see the pitch.
Your 60 seconds begins now. Going up.
I'm Taylor Sparks, erotic educator and sex goddess for organicloving.com. We all know the growth of the organic industry. And it's just a matter of time before that industry made its way into the bedroom. Organic Lovin' has the only adult subscription box in the market with body-safe sex toy materials, all-natural ingredients, and quality sex-positive books. The subscription market has been growing at a rate of 200% per year, and between 2013 and 2016, there has been an increase in 3,000% of website traffic to the subscription box websites with over 21 million visitors. We offer three salacious boxes, the Try Me box, which is monthly, and the Tease Me and Indulge Me boxes, which are quarterly, all filled with full-size travel and sample sizes of organic lubricants, vegan condoms, quality-based safe sex toys.
Five,
we're asking
$100,000
for an investment for 25% of our company. Thank you.
I'm in.
Obviously.
I'm in. How are they going to distribute this is what I want to know.
It's a subscription box.
No, I know, but I mean, how are you going to get eyeballs to buy it?
E-commerce, social media. It's,
no problem.
You can go so sexy
with
this. Because it's disruptive, and people love that.
I think we have to open it up.
Absolutely. I think there's something here.
Yeah. Oh, my God. I'm obsessed. Open the doors.
Welcome to the boardroom.
Yes!
How are you all?
Finally, some of the good ideas.
These are samples for
us. They are. You have one for each of you, one for him.
I want to see the products.
One for you.
Oh, thank you.
This is our Try Me box. So the travel sizes and sample sizes of either organic lubricants, eco-friendly sex toys, and everyone gets a quality sex-positive book. In addition to the subscription box, this is just one revenue stream. We are actually a full-service e-commerce company.
Okay.
We also do adults-only vacations. I actually present worldwide, and Paris comes with me. As an erotic educator, I educate people on why they should be using chemical-free intimate body products.
So first of all, does it work, the vegan condom? This is like an important question.
And it's not a lettuce wrap. You can't eat it. So
that was my next question.
So what makes that
vegan?
Yeah.
So the difference between a standard condom and a vegan condom, a vegan condom's ones come from a sustainable rubber tree.
Okay.
Two, they're not tested on animals because your standard condoms are tested on horses and sheep. Number three, they're triple washed and they don't have any milk casein on them. People who are vegan don't like any animal byproducts, so that powdery substance is milk casein.
Sure.
But most importantly, the lubricant on it is natural.
That's
so
great.
So women sometimes get irritated with the chemicals that are in, say, lubricants.
Question, this is a big industry. It's a fun idea.
Yes.
But how are you going to get eyeballs and credit cards?
Well, because we are a full-service e-commerce company, we have a lot of clients come to us just looking for products. And then they see there's an actual way to get a subscription.
Okay.
But we do travel worldwide, and I present these boxes and all of our products at the seminars.
Do you have revenue?
Yes, we did. Last year, we did $129,000.
How is this defensible? What would prevent someone else from coming up with this concept and doing it?
Well, they haven't done it yet. The organic industry's there. It already exists. Mm-hmm. And now it's some of these companies have made their way into the bedroom with the products, but they haven't said, hey, let's do a box or let's market to this adult-only industry.
I think a big value, too, is that for every product, there's education. That's her international appeal.
On a deal basis there, I would come at this differently. We'd lend you $100,000 and take a percentage of each box. And that gets you focused on selling boxes. That's how I would come at this.
Absolutely.
I like that.
Yeah.
Then there would be like a better road to do
like 5%
more
of box sales, something like that.
No equity, like equity kicker.
The 5% of box sales is the kicker.
Off the top?
I would like to see
like
the kicker, but...
You want to see some warrants on the end of the loan?
Yeah.
Yeah, okay.
Some warrant
coverage.
So yeah. What we mean is we'd structure a loan and a certain portion of each box comes back to paying down the loan.
Yeah.
Because that way we're both completely aligned. And then
we sell more boxes.
Like at the end of the loan, once the loan's repaid, then at that point we own 10% equity.
Correct. 10% kicker.
I'm sorry.
Okay, so we have a deal?
We have a deal.
We have a deal.
Yay! Yay! Oh my God, I'm so excited.
Oh my God, this means
so much.
Amazing growth. This means great help, and I'm thrilled. I'm beyond thrilled.
Has everything I like. Great people, great passion, and great profit.
Yeah. And it's
potential.
Sexy. I love them.
She's got a great vibe.
Mm-hmm.
We're gonna make money on this deal.
Yeah.
Your 60 seconds begins now. Going up.
It's no secret that women love their college or university. In fact, they showcase their school pride by the merchandise that they wear. However, college students and alumni are sick and tired of boring and basic t-shirts and jerseys to showcase their college pride. They want something a little more stylish and sophisticated. And here's how I can help. My name is Quinn Conyers, and I'm the proud chief fashion officer of the Purse Paparazzi. And I allow women to carry what they care about. My bag business specializes in custom purses for women who are members of a sorority or who attended a college. Currently, we are licensed with 11 universities and 4 sororities, but it's time to expand our brand.
It's been done.
Overdone.
In 2017, we generated over $189,000 in sales. And today, I'm seeking a $180,000 investment for a 15% equity stake in my company so I can create more products in my purse family. So let's say goodbye to boring and basic t-shirts and jerseys. For all those college women out there who want to showcase their college pride. So who wins?
Nice pitch.
Good pitch.
Yeah. I loved her energy. I liked her energy.
What she's doing.
Yeah.
Is there a market for that?
Is her product the bag?
Yeah, that dual bag.
It's that bag. She's going to slap a sticker on a bag. I'm kind of not feeling it, but she did do sales.
$189,000.
She wants $2.7 million.
And she's smart to go after the universities because she knows to go to the champion instead of trying to do direct sales as much.
I think she had a great 2017. Maybe this could get to be twice as big.
Yeah.
But twice as big is...
She doesn't need our money. She can just go out and just hit the pavement.
Yeah.
And, you know?
Yeah, I agree.
Yeah. I'd say maybe.
Not a big enough idea.
Yeah, I agree.
All right, let's send her down, Rach.
Yeah. Send her down.
Going down.
Why not? I mean, I think it was at least worth a conversation. I know I have an awesome product, but maybe I just wasn't what the judges were looking for.
I need more. Let's see the next pitch. Uh-oh.
I'm just thinking Blues Brothers.
60 seconds begins now. Going up.
Hey guys, my name's James Ingalls, and I'm a film director.
Hey, my name's Alan Velez, and I'm an actor.
One of the hardest parts of filmmaking today, whether amateur or professional, is putting together a cast and crew.
As an actor, I personally know how hard it is to find gigs around the location. The current solution for this are talent agencies, which cost hundreds to even thousands of dollars.
But we have a better solution called FilmStart, a social media application specifically designed for filmmakers and by filmmakers.
Think of Tinder or LinkedIn, but for filmmaking. Our app will help filmmakers find and connect with local directors, screenwriters, stunt performers, actors, etc.
We already have one of the top filmmaking apps on Google Play called The Filmmakers Project, and are looking to expand the brand. After a survey, more than one-third of our users expressed interest in FilmStart.
We are seeking $90,000 for 15% of the company. The money will go directly towards the development of the application for both iOS and Android.
There are over 1 million film students in the US today and 2 million filmmakers working in the industry, but not a single product or service like ours currently exists.
So, are you guys interested in helping us create FilmStart?
2, 1, time's up.
So my problem is that eventually the platforms like Tinder are going to start in different genres, and they already own all the customers.
Right, and they already have the tech.
It's not defensible.
But it could be an application that is developed and then acquired by a Tinder.
Well, they already have the platform. They just need different people. You could take Tinder today and do Tinder for anything.
Mm-hmm.
Cooking, golf,
sure.
Film stuff.
Bumble's doing it
Bumble,
really well.
Bumble, right.
One more hug for good luck.
They're friendly.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, they like each other.
I like that. I like the pitch. I thought it was clean
oh, yeah.
pitch.
Yeah.
Smooth.
They're used to being on camera.
Cross my fingers, man.
Yeah.
I don't know. What do we say?
not a big enough idea, and for the small amount of money, I don't know what gets done with 90 grand.
Mm-hmm. I like the idea of investing into apps, but you know, if we can't validate it based on your experience.
Yeah, I mean, I think that there's a market for that, but our casting directors, our filmmakers really gonna use an app? They might
great
just wanna
point
go to the same people they've been
that's
going to for so
point
long.
It's intense. This is intense.
I'm okay with out.
Yeah, okay.
You're out, okay.
Yeah. I am as well.
Send him down.
Agree.
Going down.
All right. The judges didn't like it.
Unfortunately,
but
yeah. No. Keep on going.
Yeah, we just keep going.
Yeah.
Try to get more investors. If this was a movie, this would be like one of those sports movies where, you know, they have that down point right before the final victory.
Ready, judges? Let's hear the next pitch.
Your 60 seconds begins now. Going up.
Advertising and marketing has become the largest industry in the world. And with ad fraud becoming a reality at $18 billion in ad fraud in 2018, brands are struggling to reach consumers. My name is Lorraine Lumpkin, and having been the former head of client development for the largest agency in the world based in New York City, I know the reality of ad fraud and the impact it's having on businesses. My company, Custom Blockchain Solutions, has developed a solution and a protocol to stop ad fraud called Blockchain for Media. It will actually detect fake sites, block ads that are being run by ad bots, and save advertisers money. We are confident in the solution because my partner has been in the software development space for over 12 years. They are profitable. We have over 30 developers. And I will be the head of the marketing for the initiative.
Time's up.
We didn't mention like influencers or social media, and that's like a huge part of marketing. So is this only sites?
I don't know.
There's no valuation, no ask. It makes it difficult.
I'm kind of meh on this one.
Meh.
I'm interested. She's got a lot of experience and sounds like a big team, so I'm guessing there's revenue, and I'm curious. We have some important questions to
ask. Let's do it.
I'm gonna go with you guys, whatever you guys pick.
Open the doors.
Welcome to the boardroom.
Yes! Hi.
Hi.
Congratulations.
Thank you. I'm so excited to be here.
You piqued our curiosity, but I think to get focused, I'd like to start with Rachel. You have a great question.
Yeah, so my area is all about social media, and you didn't really touch on that at all. I know, obviously, blogs is what you're talking about, but do you have any space there where you can verify accounts at scale?
Yes, actually, blogs are one small part of it. It is the whole digital ecosystem. We have a proprietary technology that's already working in Europe that detects at a 99.9% accuracy that it is a human and not a bot. So my technical partners created this, so I am not the technical, but it actually goes through to validate a token.
Okay.
It works with any programmatic system. It will plug into their interface. The ad will be validated. The person will be validated that they're a human. There's a red indicator here with an X.
Okay.
If it's not a human, if it's not a real site, or whether a lot of fraudulent websites, almost a million fraudulent websites right now.
Can I see that?
Yes.
Pretend like I know what I'm doing.
Yeah. I know, I'm like, I fell asleep a little bit, but I think it's great.
How do you make money?
We make money by a CPM model. So we have added 25 cents per CPM, which is a marginal investment for any brand.
So you're buying insurance for 25 cents?
Yes. No one's dealing with the fraud. So calculating the model with $50 billion in ad spend, if 10% of the ads ran through that, it equates to like over $300 million.
So what's your ask?
My ask is $1 million to allow us to dedicate 5 developers to complete the development phase, get the marketing strategy lined up, and brands specifically that we already know are so angry about the ad business and what's happening with it. We already have a Microsoft certified partnership. We are working with IBM and are in talks with Oracle.
What's the valuation implied here?
10%.
Okay.
We have an established team.
Are those your developers or are they outsourced?
Yeah, that was my question.
They are actually out of Poland, and they are custom software developers who've been in business for 12 years.
So that's a high pre-money valuation.
I think what concerns me a little bit is that you're talking about taking the funds and then investing in marketing strategy. I feel like you kind of need to walk in with a strategy that you know is going to work.
I have a strategy. What I'm saying is that I need salespeople to go out and engage with the agencies. That is a labor-intense effort.
I know that you could get in front front of the brands, et cetera.
I've been talking to them already.
The biggest issue I have is that I can't throw $1 million at an idea pre-money at a $10 million valuation.
No, I agree.
Well, there's no working model either. I mean, this is all on the come.
Yeah.
This is all, I get developers are going to come up with something in 6 months and it's going to go gold.
Yeah.
And we nothing you can really look at right today and say it's worth $10 million.
Does it take you this full million to get to proof of concept?
Or no, it's roughly $250,000 for the development time.
The million for $10 million valuation, I don't think any of us are there.
No.
You might want to start out with going and raise $250,000 from a smaller group, get the development done, come back with something that's a little bit more tangible.
I agree with you, Greg. I would say one of two things. We can either start now with our own round at, you know, $250,000, but we're going to ask for that same 10% at that amount. Or you go out and see what you can raise up the million, mm-hmm. and then we might come in and participate in that round. You know, it's what you want to do, which direction you want to go.
So I think we have a deal at $250,000.
For 10%.
For 10%.
Okay.
Awesome. Great, thanks.
Awesome.
Great.
Congratulations.
Thank
you. I'm like ecstatic. I can't wait to call my partners and let them know what happened.
To support any of these entrepreneurs through crowdfunding, go to entrepreneur.com/elevator pitch. Coming up on the next Entrepreneur Elevator Pitch.
Let's go. Let's make some money.
I don't even think you need us.
Do your nuts taste like beer? Because ours sure do. Ugh.
To apply for season 3, go to entrepreneur.com/elevator pitch.